Okay, this will be like a little update on the Stihl Hatchet here. So I've been messing around with it for a while, worked on it and tried it, and first time I drove the head on more and tried to drive the wedges in and stuff, and it didn't seem to take. Got loose again, so ended up driving the handle off, and I kept filing on it. You can probably see the marks there. I filed on it, drove it on, filed on it, and I kind of tried to get it to a nice sort of gradual slope that so the head would go on. It would start to plow wood, but it would get kind of nice and tight here. Slide up, you know, over the thing here. It's got pretty good thickness here, so it you get something to work with. Anyway, I think I've probably moved the head on half inch, I guess. I think that's about how much was out here that I've cut off overall. So last time I got messing with it, I took the handle off. The wooden wedges that were in here originally, they had some major issues of like backing out, and you couldn't drive them in anymore. And I don't know, it looks like they've been glued in, and then when I was putting linseed oil to it, I don't know if the glue turned into like this slimy crap, like it was like a waxy kind of, it was weird. Anyway, like the wedges had no, like they would back out like right easy, so end up picking them out. I picked out the round wedge here, and I had a wooden wedge. It was like these little kits or sets you buy that have has like a wooden wedge and two metal step wedges. I'd use the metal wedges, but anyway, I put in the new wooden wedge, which I don't know what the hell's made of. Like, looks like almost like popple or some sort of Brazilian jungle wood or Chinese chew wood or something. I don't know what it is. Like, it looks like softwood. But so I put that in, put the round wedge back in. I got it a little bit, head's a little bit up, or the handle's a little bit, you know, proud. Drove that in and start feeding it linseed oil, and it's like the wedge, it sucked it up like a sponge. And I painted it a little bit around here and stuff. And I was doing a little bit of hacking today, and it doesn't seem to have budged at all, so I kind of think it might be fixed, but the gap that was here is pretty much gone. There's no gap there. There's a tiny bit of a gap in the front part there, but I think that's, like, originally that's where the wedge kind of went there. But, so I had to, I cut the slot for the, I took the handle off, like, the slot for the wooden wedge ended up being too high up, because I cut so much of the top of the head off, so I had to cut that down a bit further, so the wooden wedge had a place to go. If it persists, I might put a metal wedge, another metal wedge, like going this way, or like a real smallish one or something. I don't know. But we'll see. It seems to be decent now. Just put a bunch of wood and stuff today and chopped it into the block, and I couldn't get it to wiggle around or anything. But so now I'm just putting linseed oil onto it a bunch. It seems to pretty much be the limit that it's going to take. It's not sucking it up like it did, so it's still, you can see it's still sort of sitting on the surface there now. So. But, anyway. I like the thing. Like, it's got a decent head. Like, it doesn't dull or anything. Like, it's not that it's sharp to start with, but the edge is, retention seems pretty decent on this thing, so. I'm kind of thinking they're not the same head as the, there's the big Baco friggin' debacle or whatever the hell you want to call it. Wrangler Star got all, you know, has big ass videos about it, but, you sharpen it down to a ridiculously thin edge and then it rolled over. Had some, like, heat treatment issues or something, but I think the Baco heads are, like, made in Spain, according to him, but hard to say. But these Stihl ones, far as I can find, they're made by Helco in Germany, but they have a good name for the steel on the head is decent. They just kind of the handle is fitted crappy, is kind of seems fairly normal with a lot of factory built axes now, but even like the handmade, like the Swedish ones, a lot of the ones you get from them are like duds now too. The handles are not seated, like they're seated okay, but they're not really seated the way a lot of people think they should be. Like they drive them on until the little ears plow wood, and it's not really that seated that well normally in the back and the front sometimes, and then they drive the wedges in and mushroom it out on the top, so then it's sort of tight just at the bottom where the ears are and tight at the top, so actually in the middle there's hell, there's nothing there. Like that's kind of one thing this one had going against it too. Like they drove it on, it bottomed out, and then they drove the wedges in it, but when I knocked the handle off initially, there was, it seemed to be have no contact, like in about like this part of the head and the handle. Like you can see where the orange paint had kind of rubbed off on the bottom and at the very top here, but in between there was like nothing. So that's like it had a little bit of space in the front and stuff. That's why it had this wiggle to it. And but now it seems to be. So I shaved it down. It's fairly tight. The head has contact pretty much with most of the eye here now, and it's not that wide on it, so it's kind of important, I guess, that it has a lot of friction there. So, and I'm putting the old linseed oil to it, it's swelled up a bit, I believe. It looks like it has. So. But there's, I can see there's a little bit of a line there where it was driven onto, and it hasn't backed past that, so I did do a little bit of sort of semi-aggressive splitting, but maybe we'll do a little bit more stuff and see if I can get it to move. But I think she's fairly good now. But if I do have more issues, then yeah, as I said, I might just add another metal wedge. I'm not sure where I can put it, because those round wedges are kind of like, the round wedge won't go any farther. Like I got a piece of steel tube to beat on that, and it's pretty much where it is. It's there. So, but I might be able to put another wedge there or something, but anyway, it's a good learning experience, I guess. So you sort of fix these friggin' things, so. But anyway, I guess, so yeah, so overall, so there's sort of a axe. You probably should go in and look at them before you buy one, but overall, I'm happy with it. You know, it's like a $30 or $40 axe. And it's got a better, way better head than a lot of other, like, really cheapy hatchets and stuff.